Alright, in this video we're going to look at finding components of vectors along another vector and projections of vectors onto other vectors. So, to figure out the component of B onto A, we take the dot product A dot B and we divide that by the magnitude of vector A. And then, to figure out the projection of vector B along vector A, we take A dot B over A dot A and multiply that by vector A. Equivalently, we can write that as a dot b over the magnitude of a squared, again, times vector a. So if I leave off any of the little lines, again, those indicate vectors. Everything I'm talking about here is vectors, so hopefully I won't accidentally do that. Okay, so what we want to do is we're going to find both the component of b along a and also the vector projection of b along a for these given vectors. Alright, so again, to do to figure out the component of vector B along A, again, we take the dot product, A dot B, and then we divide that by the magnitude of vector A. So to do the dot product, again, we just multiply respective components. So 1 times 2 will be 2. We'll take 2 times negative 1, that'll be negative 2. Then we'll add to that 3 times 4, which is going to be 12. We'll divide that by the magnitude of vector A. Well, the magnitude, we just square the components. So 1 squared is 1, 2 squared is 4, 3 squared is going to be 9. And now we can just simplify this. So 2 plus negative 2 is 0. We'll have 12 on top. In the denominator, it looks like we're going to have the square root of 14. So that's our component of vector B along vector A. To do the projection of B along A, again, the formula for that, we just said, was A dot B. And I'm going to use this slightly different. Instead of doing A dot A, I'm going to take the magnitude squared, because we've already figured out the magnitude. And then we'll multiply that by vector A. Well, again, we figured out what A dot B was. That's what we had in the numerator a second ago. That's just going to be 12. We can take the magnitude of vector A and square it. Well, again, the denominator was the magnitude, so we'll just take the square root of 14 and square it, and that'll just leave us with 14. And then we multiply that by our vector A. So again, vector A had components 1, 2, 3. Well, let's see, I guess this reduces to 6 over 7. And again, we're just going to multiply. So recall, when you have a constant out front, we just multiply each component by that number. So we'll get 6 over 7 times 1, which will just be 6 over 7. We'll get 6 over 7 times 2, which will give us 12 over 7. And then we'll multiply 6 over 7 times 3. That'll give us 18 over 7. And now we have our vector projection.